After creating my Akido Connect account using my personal email address and invite code, I enter my credentials into the application and log in. Once I'm signed in, I click Details. Under Details, I can see both the Lhasa hotline information and the Akido Technical Assistance hotline. If I have questions about the count, I will contact my deployment site coordinator or the Lhasa hotline. If I'm having issues with the application, I will call the Akido Technical Assistance hotline. Next, I will assign myself census tracks. To do that, I will go to the section that reads, Add Tracks to My List. Then I'll begin entering my census track number. I see that the application will suggest census tracks based on the information I have entered. Once I see the census track that I need, I will select the Add button. Now my census tracks are under the Additional Map Areas. If at any point in time I need to remove that census tract from my list, I will merely select the Remove button. By selecting the census track, I am redirected to the home screen and I can see an outline of my census tract assignment. Once I've driven or walked to my assigned census tract, I am ready to start counting. I then click Start Counting. The application will have me confirm which census tracts I'm about to count from the drop-down menu. Next, I'm prompted to complete a pre-count survey. I'm asked to enter my phone number, my partner's full name, my partner's email address, and my partner's phone number. I can also indicate if I have a second partner. After completing the pre-count survey, I'm brought back to the home screen. And on the home screen, I see that route tracking has started. This occurs so that I can keep track of which areas I have and have not covered. I can select the Stop Tracking button in case I need to take a break or pause tracking, and I can select Start Tracking when I am ready to resume. I'm now ready to start inputting my visual tally. I will submit separate data tallies for each sections of the block, for each group or encampment that I see. For instance, if there are separate groups of people throughout the block, I can submit a separate tally survey for each group that I see. To do that, I will select Add Data. I will confirm that I am submitting a record for the visual count survey. When I see a new individual, family, or dwelling, I will start to input my visual tally. I will indicate if I observe a family unit. Please remember that a family unit must have at least one adult over 18 and at least one child under 18. I will not wait until I have canvassed the entire block to submit my tally. Once I enter the data, I click Submit and am returned to my map. On this screen, I can zoom in and see that a pin has dropped where I added the data. I can also view the list to see the data that has been previously added. When I am done, I will select View Map and I am returned to my home screen. When I come across a new visual count, I will repeat the process until I've canvassed the entire census tract. Once my entire census tract has been covered, I will click Finish Counting. I'm then prompted to complete a finish counting survey. This survey allows my coordinator to know that I finished canvassing the entire assigned area. If I wasn't able to complete a visual count on the entire census tract, I'm prompted to add notes to let my site coordinator know. I click Finish, and now I've completed counting for this census tract. If I have additional census tract assignments, I will repeat the process again.